Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. News in detail. With a motive to draw Union Minister Amit Shah's attention to the flourishing narcotics use and trade which has come to light in the second capital of the state, ex-MLA Dr. Ashish Deshmukh has recently written a letter demanding CBI and NCB probe and action on this concern. According to the data of National Crime Record Bureau for the year 2019, the state of Maharashtra reported an extremely high incidence of 2,256 individuals committing suicide due to various reasons. Many of these unnatural deaths have been attributed to the addiction to the narcotic variety of drugs. The same report revealed that in Nagpur, 636 people committed suicide last year. The serious issue needs to be dealt with urgently and decisively, Deshmukh demanded. This weekend, Janta Curfew was implemented in the city as a part of the administration's initiative to bring positive cases and casualties to as low as extent as possible. On Saturday and Sunday, citizens gave a mixed response to Janta Curfew. While in some areas of the city, the streets and public places were largely deserted, in other areas, the situation was exactly the opposite. Mayor Sandeep Joshi and former Energy Minister Chandrasekhar Bavankule were seen appealing to people to stay indoors as far as possible. Is adventure out only for important work? Bavankule lambasted the government and held it responsible for the rise in corona positive cases and casualties in the city. With the CM in Mumbai and the Deputy CM in Pune, no senior minister or government official was giving adequate attention to the serious situation prevailing in Nagpur, Bavankule alleged. Through the initiative of former Nagpur Municipal Commissioner Tukaram Munde, a hospital based in a southern locality of the city has been converted into a COVID hospital around 4 months ago in order to cater to the rising number of corona positive patients in the city. The authorities from the NMC and other organizations spent around Rs 18 lakh of public money for equipping the hospital with state-of-the-art facilities and equipment. But even after 4 months, the facility is not being utilized to cater to the purpose of COVID-19 patients' treatment. Mayor Sandeep Joshi had recently brought the issue to notice and said that on one hand, patients are not getting beds and medical treatment on time, which is contributing to the rise in corona positive cases and death in the city. And on the other, due to the negligence of some officials, such instances of misuse of public facilities are also occurring. Tragedy struck the families of three youth from Nagpur when they were drawn in the Kola River while immersing the ashes of their common friend's deceased grandmother at the Killer Kolar Ghat near Dahegaon on Chindwara Road on Saturday evening. While immersing the ashes, Akash suddenly lost balance and slipped into the river. Seeing Akash in danger, Harshit jumped into the river in order to save him, but in process, he too ended up venturing deep into the river. Ultimately, Nayan too jumped to save his friend, but tragically, all three ended up drowning. The bodies of three youths, Akash Rajendra Rawat, Harshit Raju Edwan, and Nayan Idkar, were fished out by State Disaster Response Force personnel after an extensive search operation. A pall of gloom has descended in their areas of residence, Rameshwari Mahal and Babul Kheda. May news of their a pall of gloom has descended in their areas of residence, Rameshwari Mahal and Babul Kheda, when news of their untimely demise broke out. The Health Committee Chief of Nagpur Municipal Corporation, Virendra Kukreja, tested positive for COVID-19 on a Sunday for the second time. Apart from Kukreja, his family of two children and a wife also tested positive. Kukreja appealed to the people who came in contact with him in the past 7 days to get their test done. He assured that he would come out of this and get back to serving people. Kukreja had earlier tested positive in the first week of August. As many as 54 persons succumbed to the COVID-19 pandemic on Sunday. With this, the cumulative death toll in the district has now reached to 2,044. On the other hand, as many as 1,610 persons have gone home after recovery and obtaining permission from authorities. With this, the total number of recovered patients is now 51,556, including 29,257 patients who recovered during home isolation and treatment. The recovery rate of the district is at 80.86%. The total corona positive active cases in the district is now 10,157, with 1,226 positive cases coming to light. While giving a breakup of the deaths, medical official revealed that out of the total casualties, 337 and 1,523 victims are hailing from the rural and urban areas of the district respectively, while 184 persons are from outside Nagpur. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBCN News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care.